Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to Bioshock, where we are still going through our Let's Replay series, where we try to delve a bit deeper into the secrets of this game. And we're still in the office where we found a research camera, and as you can see, I didn't mention that in the previous episode, but this is the office of that Sullivan man that we heard an AccuVox of before. And he was researching something fishy, well, no pun intended, in Fontaine Fisheries apparently. Because maybe something that Peach Wilkins isn't telling us. But hey, there we go. Stuff is going on again. I'm gonna use Electrobolt for this. Because now we can actually make a picture of a spider, a normal splicer in action, a leadhead splicer. Quality research photo with an A rating. And that just puts our leadhead splicer research to its next level. So now we have increased damage. And they're also vulnerable to anti-personnel rounds. Let's quickly switch to the wrench and do that! Yeah, I think I know you. So the Gatherer's Garden here has been destroyed clearly by an explosion, which this allows us to be able to use it. But as you can see down there, there's another thingy! I think it's a plasmid, because now the way we came is completely blocked. I think this is, yeah, this was the hole that we came through originally. But we can't go there anymore. What we can do is go through this hole in the wall, and we can power up with Security Bullseye, a free plasmid that allows us to tag enemies so they are attacked by security apparatuses that are not under our control as well. Are those pesky security cameras getting you down? Simply tag your enemies with our photoelectric insects, and those cameras and turrets become your best friend. Spy Security Bullseye today. I'm not gonna do that because it's not that useful, but I am gonna do something else now that we have that, because that splicer is clearly there to show you how that works. But I'm gonna go to the gene bank here and swap out Hypnotize Big Daddy with the decoy that we have, the target dummy, so that I can show you how that works, because I can make actually a copy of myself. Look at that. Not that we need that right now, because I'm just gonna shoot that guy. So let's see here. I don't think I can actually take a picture from this far away. No, look at that. It's not really okay. So let's just kill that guy. What we can do is we can actually research security devices as well. So the camera we see over there, we can actually take a picture of as well if you're getting. Let's try to come pretty close and take it. There we go. And now we have an A rating for the security camera. And we get increased damage against the camera, which doesn't really do much. And security cameras are vulnerable to armor-piercing rounds and electricity. But the next levels, are the higher levels, give nicer rewards, as you will see in the future. So let's hack this thing again. There we go. And let's hack the ammo bandito as well. That was a bit of a harder one. I took damage once, but let's see. We can actually buy electric bucks in this one. So I'm gonna do that twice. We have the cash to do so. And that's all the electric bucks there are in this thing, apparently. Let's take his money as well. And now I think we can actually open this gate. Or not. Okay, not apparently. I'm wrong, but here, another auto diary. Audio diary.
This little sea slug has come along and glued together all the crazy ideas I've had since the war. It doesn't just heal damaged cells, it resurrects them. I can bend the double helix. Black can be reborn white, tall, short, weak, strong. But the slugs alone are not enough. I'll need money.
So it doesn't just heal the damaged cells, it revives them, it resurrects them. So that's another really important bit of information. Another thing she mentioned is she needed money and something else. We can also assume that that something else are in fact the little sisters. Let's see, there's another audio diary here, so here we go again. Nope, I don't want to open that, just want to start that.
If things weren't bad enough, it seems that even our water system sprung a leak. Yep, that's right. irrigation system in Arcadia is taking on seawater. I told Mr. Ryan when we were building this place. You have the research camera? Good. Guess it's time to get to work for old Peachy. Take the man's pictures and let's get the hell out of this place.
I'm gonna restart that audio diary because it had some interesting tidbits of information.
Seems that even our water system sprung a leak. Yep.
Here's the leak.
Irrigation system in Arcadia is taking on seawater. I told Mr. Ryan when we were building this place, either you build her like a bathtub, or she's gonna turn into a sewer. No, McDonough, he said. We're not gonna build no bathtub. We're gonna build Eden.
So McDonough is one of the engineers that tried to build this place. Well, not tried, they succeeded. But because of some decisions that Ryan took, the way it's built is now failing the entire city. So the he said that the irrigation system in Arcadia was taking on salt water, which is of course not good for the vegetation over there. And also indicates that Arcadia is the place where they actually have real vegetation. And we'll get to Arcadia soon enough. Let's hack this thing as well. There we go, another heal station for us, and we're actually doing pretty well on the health and Eve side of things. So we're heading towards the Jet Postal, and the fighting McDonald's over there, and the Jet Postal is on the rise. So there's a camera over there, might want to hack that first. There we go again. And I think there's another splicer close. That were cigarettes. That wasn't good for my health. There we go. Do have to be careful that I don't shoot too many of those, because I need to use that camera as well. So this is where we actually need to be. Where the hell did he go? So that's two guys right in front of the camera. And let's head back towards it. There we go. Now we wait for the spider splicer to appear, shock it, and then we can take a pretty... There we have another spider splicer we can take a photo of. Let's take a few, because if we take a few, we can actually upgrade that. But now we have a problem. We trigger the security alert. So spider splicer organs can be used, like first aid kits is something that we got as a bonus. But now we have a problem. Security alert incoming. So now I'm going to use my shorty, go with the decoy, place it over here, let the alarm just run its course. Oh! Hi, I forgot about you. So now the turrets should be pretty... Oh! Nope, turrets don't care. I thought turrets did their best. Wait a second. There should be a bolt shutdown thingy here pretty closely. Oh, there's actually one right here on the right. Hi. Let's take some bandages on the way and deactivate it. No. Oh, for fuck's sake. Okay. Then let's just shotgun the thing. Wow, now I can hack. I can hack this bolt as well. There we go. Our first picture of a security bolt, which allows us to do extra damage as well. And now let's go back to the shotgun. I wonder if I should hack this thing. Whether we should or shouldn't, I just did. So let's check out the spider splicer organ. So now we can take those, and those just function as health kit as well. So every spider splicer we kill will now always contain a health kit. I want the bandages, thank you. There we go. I think there's another proximity mine. Yeah, there we go. There's something up there as well. Are those normal shotgun? Yeah. normal shotgun shells. So now this bot is gonna follow us around a bit. Don't need to reload this thing. There's a bit of money around here. Need to take a keep an eye on everything, because there's a lot here. The camera, as you might have seen, also has an ammo type. It uses film that allows you to take pictures. So every time you take a picture, you lose one shot of your film. Logically. Didn't need to explain that, probably. There we go. More money. A few pep bars that I can eat to fill up the rest of my health. And a bit more film. So now, we only need to research one more... those are normal machine gun rounds. I can't pick up that. One more spider splicer. So if we're lucky, we might find one soon. And as you remember, we also never took care of our lady female spider splicer. So that's something as well. So, death penalty in Rapture.
The death penalty in Rapture. Council's in an uproar. Riots in the streets, they say. But this is the time for leadership. Action must be taken against the smugglers. Any contact with the surface exposes Rapture to the very parasites we fled from. A few stretched necks are a small price to pay for our ordeals.
So there was another camera up there that contained 12 more film. If you want to make that a unit. We also have another vending machine we can hack. There we go. Let's see what's inside. More electric buck. I thought I bought 12 already before. But hey, never mind. I'm gonna keep it like that. Don't know about maybe one more Eve hypo. Yeah. We spent enough money already. So now, this should be fine. This is guarded by that camera, so we should be okay to... Hacking cameras is really handy, because you always get a notification if one of the splicers gets behind you. So, okay. Are you going? Okay, bye. There we go, an action shot. And we get a bonus for action shots. And we get a tonic, splicing scrounger. Is like having a sixth sense. You'll spot things you'd otherwise miss and discover things you'd otherwise leave behind. With Scrounger, you'll swear you have X-ray vision. And what that actually does is when searching containers or corpses, you can search again to gain different loot. It has its uses, and I'm gonna swap that for Eve Link. But, oh, that was not what I wanted to do. Because that can give us a lot of extra loot, so... We're in the way of our own bot again.
You don't.
There we go, another shot. We're gonna be able to research lead head splicers fast, because, well, there's lead head splicers everywhere. No, don't shoot. He's dead. He's dead. So as you can see, we can already do a hell of a lot more damage to those guys than we could before. Maybe a bit of more information about what we're about to enter. The Fighting McDonough's Tavern is a tavern held by two brothers, if I'm not mistaken. One of the McDonough we already heard, because he was the one that was talking about the leaks in Rapture. Because he's not only a bartender, he doesn't only own this tavern, but he also, well, made Rapture. So let's hack this vending machine as well. There we go. I don't think there's anything, yeah, not really of interest. Skilled hacker, probably... A number of times I needed to hack something. There we go. So let's head into the tavern first, I think. Because there's a lot of other stuff here. It's a really interesting area, and I think it's largely optional as well. But we need to be careful, because there's a lot of extra stuff here. And cameras. So there we go. Lead head splicers. Increased damage plus plus. So now we can two-hit these guys. And kill them pretty easily with a wrench. There we go. So let's take a look, good look around. Working late again. From Andrew Ryan.
Diane, I'm sorry, but I'll be late again tonight. Rosenberg
Diane.
Is to speak about this Fontaine business. I'm trying to build a proper financial market, and this idiot keeps going on about this genetic modification, that... I'll go spend an hour pretending to pay attention to the poor fellow and be home as soon as I can.
So, there we go. Diane is, of course, Diane McClintock, the woman we've heard before that told us that Andrew Ryan told her he loved her, but that wasn't all that clear. She also went with to Steinman to fix the damage done by the attack on New Year's Eve. There's another audio diary here, the smuggling ring.
I'm closing in on the whole ring. I'd pat myself on the back, but let's face it. Exactly bloodthirsty desperados we're talking about. Rapture's full of poets, artists, and tennis players, not hired guerrillas. But this leader of theirs, this Fontaine, he seems to know his way around the grift. He keeps his nose clean, but not so clean that the right people don't know he's not to be trifled.
So there we have a Nitro Splicer, and Sullivan, of course, was talking about the smuggler's ring ruled by Fontaine, apparently. So Nitro Splicer's damage increased. And there he goes. And for some reason, I still took damage of an explosion that was behind the corner there. Not really sure how that works. We can open these bot room stalls by inserting a few credits. So there we go, let's open these up. Look at how fancy this toilet looks. There's machine gun rounds, but we can't really use that, so let's open this one as well. And there's a tiny little hole in here that you can actually see a few items through, a few very valuable items, two proximity mines and an Eve hypo. And that's about it, I think. I don't think there's anything else around here aside from that Nitro Splicer. Because now we can search again, and that gives us a shot at getting something new if the container was empty before. So we can do that with every container. I'm gonna try to keep that a bit limited, because otherwise we're constantly looting and not doing anything else. Yes, I've done something. God damn it. Woman, get over here. So thanks for the picture. And let's take her out. Let's search again. There we go, first aid kit. So sometimes it's really, really worth the trouble. Let's reload that. And now we have, again, two more areas we can go to. We can zap this door and continue over here. Which I think... I'm doubting myself right now. Let's go in here first. So, goodbye, you. Seriously? And goodbye, you. So this is the wine cellar, as you might call it. Where the McDonald's stored their liquor. There's actually something in here as well. Oh yeah, I remember this room, right. So there's another audio diary here. Rapture changing.
Rapture's changing, but Ryan can't see the wolves in the woods. This Fontaine fella, he's a crook and a proper tea leaf, but he's got the Adam, and that makes him the governor. Sinking the profits back into bigger and better plasmids, building them Fontaine poorhouses, more like Fontaine recruiting centers. Before we know it, Bo's gonna have an army of splicers. We're
going to
have ourselves a whole heap of miseries.
So McDonough's two cents about the situation is that, well, Fontaine has access to all the Adam, and that makes him the de facto ruler of the city. So there's another turret here. And since a lot of people were addicted to Adam, which turned them in turn into splicers, caused the Fontaine to have quite an army of splicers at his disposal, just because he had access to all the atoms. So there's a buttload of frag grenades in here, which we won't be able to use. There's another splicer just entered the room. I'm gonna hack the safe first. There we go again. Another safe cracked. Automatic hap tool, 4 proximity mines, and we can't carry more than what we have. And a bit more electric buck.
Take you to space,
So the turret just spotted that splicers that came in. There we have another picture. And there we have his head caved in. So yeah, I'm gonna, as you can see, I'm starting to use the wrench a lot more than anything else. So let's head into the water here. We need to be careful for the camera over there, which shouldn't be a problem because we can just make our way around. There we go. And then of course we can also access this thing. There we go. Healing station done. Well, I'm not gonna heal. I'm not gonna heal. So let's search this guy again. Nothing. That's pretty okay. And let's heal with the bandages instead, because that was a really nice trade-off. And now we have another access panel here, which I'm just gonna use, I think. Another frag grenade. Lots of frag grenades down here, as you can see. Normal pistol rounds. Yeah, okay. And this thingy leads towards the entrance again, if I'm not mistaken, because you could access this place from the other side as well. I'm wondering, I thought there was...
The thought of your wife and child hiding in that filthy submarine makes me blood boil. Help me get them to safety and I'll be in your debt for life.
Yeah, Atlas, yeah, we're gonna do our best. So, meeting Ryan.
I met Ryan the day me and the lads were installing the bathroom plumbing up in his Cosh Park Avenue digs. Oi, says he. What's with all the brass things? General contractor had me down for the tip. Well, I says, I suppose it's the contractor then who'll be bailing out your loo once a fortnight, is it? If it's a price you're worried about, I'll be picking up the brass, so not to worry, Squire. And why would you be doing that, says he? Well, Mr. Ryan, profit or not, no man bells water out of privies built by Bill McDonough. Next day I finds out, I'm Ryan's new general contractor.
So, McDonough became the general contractor after his predecessor got bumped out pretty aggressively, is what the implication is here. So the only area we haven't checked is the upstairs of the McDonough place here. And there's another spider splicer over there, which... Did he just disappear? There we go. Another shot of the lead head splicer. And we're almost there. I'm gonna take two just to boost everything a bit. And just take him out. As we can hear, there's another one. Action shot! Or not? No action shot. So there he goes. So there we go. And he explodes again. There we go. Let's check him out. $1. Anything else? No. Okay. And nothing in there as well. So we saw the spider splicer. It's the last one we need to photograph. So let's check that again. Let's check that again. Nothing in here. And we can hear another Big Daddy, which might come in handy later. So even with Scrounger, these things barely have anything usually. I'm wondering, is there something? Yeah, okay. Something behind her? No. So the spider splicer went in here, disappeared up the hole, and probably crawled back again, because he's gone. But there are a lot of very nice things here, as you can see. Just quickly check out the crates here. We can use the Eve Hypo, can't do anything with the shotgun, armor-piercing rounds are always welcome, and the proximity mine is pretty useless right now. So let's hack the safe again. I have an auto hack, so just we'll do that. There we go. Open it up, and we have 45 armor-piercing auto rounds, 3 electric bucks, and an Eve Hypo. So that's very nice. Let's check out these crates really quickly. Nothing, nothing, and nothing again. Is there anything else here? More electric bucks we can't carry anymore because we bought a bunch.
Here to visit this.
Yes, indeed, we are here to visit the scum of the deep bloody earth. There we go. Let's photograph him. An A shot. Let's take a couple. Let's take a couple, because the music is taking over for some reason. I'm gonna have to talk above that a bit. And let's take the last one, and that just put us should put us in level 3. Increased damage +++.
We'll drown you.
Ah, oh, damn it.
Head on back to Fontaine's Fisheries when you're ready, would you kindly?
Jesus Christ. Get down. There we go. Okay, so let's reload that, and hopefully that music doesn't cause me to have to copyright this thing. There we go. Another level in the leadhead splicer. And we get static discharge 2. Is your old static discharge not slowing them down enough? Upgrade to new static discharge 2 today. And that just increases the bonus we get from a static discharge. We're not going to use that yet because we don't have enough slots. And I do like Wrench Jockey and Armored Shell both. You missed. And that's going to hurt because you missed. So that was the last part of the Leadhead Splicer research, by the way. So you don't need to go any further into that. Or do we? I'm doubting myself now. Well, we'll check the next time we come across one of those. I think there's something, yeah. So let's photograph the guy. And it's still going, so yeah, we need to still photograph these guys. So there we go. And let's whack him. For some reason, I was probably just too late to use the 1-2 punch. So this is a pretty gruesome scene. Someone has been handcuffed, and clearly there's some bowel here. Arresting Fontaine.
Mr. Ryan, I believe in Ratchet, but that doesn't mean we always win. Fontaine Futuristics is the biggest thing going in Ratchet. So let me be plain. When we arrest that Torag Fontaine for his thieving and smuggling, we must make it clear that we won't touch his business interests. We sit on the council because these poor sods trust us, not because God gave us a chance.
So we got ambushed by two leadhead splicers over there. And well, since this audio diary is right here, we might assume that McDonough is this guy murdered here because of his opinion towards Ryan, that we shouldn't touch the Fontaine business. Or maybe it's somebody else, we don't really know right now, could be somebody else. And I think there's a Big Daddy that just entered the area, which might be very nice. Okay, another person died horribly here. And shotgun ammo we can't use. Is there something behind here? No, really! Nice view, though. We have another health station, which I'm just gonna whack. What the hell? Where the hell did you come from? God damn it. So I'm just gonna whack the health station, because I'm just gonna use the dinghies here. And then, the keypad. We have the code, actually. Because this is the room of that singer. So let's check out the audio diaries again. Mariska Lutz. So there we have the My Fighting McDonald's room number 7. The code to our room is 7533. I'm gonna wait, because I kind of already forgot what the code was. That's the
room
L.
Number 7. The code to our room is 7533. We miss you, our darling child.
So that was Mariska Lutz again, and this is their room, actually. Because, well, this is pretty sad here. Because there's a dead couple over here in the corner. We can assume that that's...
today. We barely recognize her. That's her, Sam said. You're crazy, I told him. That thing? That is our Masha? But he was right. She was drawing blood out of a corpse by Fontaine Fisheries. And then when she was done, she walked off hand in hand with one of those awful golems. boss!
So this suggests that she was attacked by one of the big daddies, which she clearly survived because she's lying here next to her husband. But yeah, her daughter was turned into a little sister, probably by Tannenbaum, and when she found out, she totally freaked, of course. But there's not a tonic here. What sound is more ominous than a yammering security alarm with shortened alarm spliced? Your personal EM signatures becomes altered to interact uniquely with alarm sensors, shortening the period until you'll be free and clear. I mean, we don't really need that right now. I'm gonna try to not activate any alarms to start with. And that's the sad story of Mariska Lutz and her daughter, Masha, who turned into one of the little sisters we've been seeing all around. And, well, speak of the devil. This is a bit of a double situation, because we can actually photograph these guys as well, giving us bonuses against them. I'm gonna take a few. And which is even more interesting, we can actually take pictures of little sisters as well, which is of course a bit dangerous. There we go. And that actually gives us a small increase to our max health and Eve's, which we should do a few times, right? There we go. Of course, we're not gonna leave the opportunity here, and we're gonna try and take out this big daddy, but not before we actually take out that guy over there, which has a security bolt alongside him. Listen, Jesus Christ. Which I'm gonna try to... There we go. So that's the nitro splicer down. We can try that again. Nothing really happens, and I think the bolt just shuts down when that happens. So it's right here, we're gonna hack it. So now we have our own little bolt again. And well, we can take out the big daddy right now. Are we ready? I don't think we are, but hey. I'm gonna use a target dummy to start with, and then I'm gonna turn it aflame. Use the grenade launcher to fire. Jesus Christ. This is not good. This is not good. Jesus Christ, come on. It's really fidgety, I don't know. Sometimes I take 3 shots, sometimes I only take 2. Which is really making things harder on everybody. What the hell? Why is he... Why does he have full health? Again. Well done! That was a proximity mine. This is freaking annoying. Jesus Christ, I can't aim for shit in this thing. Let's go in here and take a bit of a breather. Okay. What is he doing? Oh, shit. But I think I can actually... No. That's annoying, but I can of course set that off by shooting just once. There we go. Let's shock him. Or maybe... Yeah, let's shock him. Now we're gonna go around the corner again. We'll try to do this all over again. Let's check out this thing. So I'm gonna need a few more. There we go. There he goes. Okay, so let's rescue the little sister. And that should be the last one in Neptune's bounty. Man, I'm fumbling with these big daddies today. Here we go. Another one done. Maybe search again. Yeah, $52. Nope. Okay. So, goodbye, little girl. Goodbye. Bye. See you next time. Oh. Oh, that's why. That's another big daddy I attacked. That's annoying. That was not what I expected, actually. I didn't expect there to be two separate big daddies so close to each other. So now that we have the research camera all completed, there's somebody over there. Put him where I can. I think that's gonna explode in my face. So a permanent 50% chance that an enemy grenade will be a dud. Whew! Okay. Okay. That just went straight through. Attack this thing. So our turret now. Yeah. Goodbye.
They sent you, didn't they? I'll shoot you.
And there he goes again. Search again. Yeah, thank you. And this guy. This thing is a dud, right? Now we're gonna... Yeah, we have been here. So that just means we have to return to Peach Wilkins. Grenade box, nothing in there. Okay. But before we do that, of course, I'm gonna have to take a little break if Atlas stops talking. Talking about his family again.
God's punishing me for bringing her back into this place. I thought this would be a better life for us. Can you imagine a bigger fool than that?
No, you're not a fool, man. You just tried to envision a better future for your family. Which you kinda did, before everything went to shit. Okay! Somebody screamed on the top of her lungs, and now that door is open. Oh, come on. Just take him. Fuck off.
This isn't over.
I'm so sick of you guys. Thank you for the dollars, though. Hello, Big Daddy. Yeah, so we need to return to Peach Wilkins, but I'm gonna take a break first. Might as well photograph this guy. Hello! So that's bringing us pretty close. No, okay. Photo not taken. And I accidentally used another health kit. But hey, let's take a little break. Let's take this Eve Hypo as well. Thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again, enormously, for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or stream. Goodbye!